Step into the cinematic world of a classic adaptation of Shakespeare's timeless tragedy, where jealousy, manipulation, and tragic fate intertwine. The 1951 film, an evocative rendition of Othello, directed by Orson Welles, captures the essence of the bard's tale with a compelling narrative and masterful performances. As you reflect on this cinematic gem, consider if there's a cherished memory associated with this movie, or perhaps unearth lesser-known facts that add depth to your appreciation. Delve into the layers of Othello's narrative, where Welles skillfully weaves a tale of love, betrayal, and the destructive power of unchecked envy. The film's noir aesthetics and the haunting performances by the cast contribute to its enduring allure. Welles himself takes on the iconic role of Othello, bringing a magnetic intensity to the character. Now, let's turn the spotlight on you. What's your most cherished memory or personal experience related to this cinematic adaptation? Have you uncovered any fascinating anecdotes or trivia that enhance your connection to this film? We'd love to hear your stories and memories in the comments below. Immerse yourself in the world of Othello, where every scene is a brushstroke on the canvas of tragedy. Share your thoughts and experiences as we celebrate the enduring impact of this cinematic masterpiece. Shakespeare's timeless tragedy, adapted to the silver screen in 1951, unfolds a gripping narrative of jealousy and deception. The film, a cinematic rendition of the bard's play, introduces us to the charismatic and esteemed Moor, a military general whose life takes a dark turn when he becomes ensnared in a web of manipulation and betrayal. The characters, including the conniving Iago and the innocent Desdemona, are brought to life by a stellar cast, delivering compelling performances that capture the essence of Shakespearean tragedy. The film's unique style blends the grandeur of classic Shakespearean language with the visual artistry of cinema, creating a powerful and emotionally charged viewing experience. Othello's impact on popular culture is profound, as it serves as a testament to the enduring relevance of Shakespeare's exploration of human nature and the destructive force of unchecked ambition and envy. The film's influence echoes through subsequent adaptations and references in various artistic forms, solidifying its place in the cinematic and cultural canon. A masterful adaptation that transcends time, Othello stands as a testament to the enduring power of Shakespearean storytelling, resonating across generations and cultures. Part of the esteemed Criterion Collection, Spine 870, the 1951 adaptation of Shakespeare's Othello has left an indelible mark on cinematic history. Notably, Orson Welles lends his voice to much of Roderigo's dialogue, adding a distinctive layer to the film's narrative. Welles, a seasoned actor, had previously been part of Dublin's Gate Theatre, founded by Micheál MacLiammóir and Hilton Edwards in 1928. MacLiammóir served as the first artistic director of Ireland's National Irish Language Theatre, the Tabernacle Theatre in Galway City, showcasing the deep cultural roots intertwined with the film. The Criterion Collection's inclusion acknowledges the film's significance, placing it among cinematic masterpieces. Welles' contribution to Roderigo's character reflects his nuanced involvement in the film's production. The connection to Dublin's Gate Theatre underscores the rich theatrical heritage influencing Welles, and by extension, the movie's artistic depth. As Spine 870, Othello's presence in the Criterion Collection solidifies its status as a timeless classic, bridging the gap between stage and screen, resonating across generations and cultures. Welles, drawing inspiration from Mantegna's oculus in the Ducal Palace, ingeniously crafted the iconic round opening in Othello's bedroom ceiling. This unique touch, reminiscent of cherubs peering down, added a visual depth to the film's setting. Interestingly, the murder scene in a Turkish bath wasn't just a creative choice, but a pragmatic one. Due to costume impoundment over non-payment, the setting for Rodrigo's demise took an unexpected turn. Suzanne Cloutier, who portrayed Desdemona, had a noteworthy journey during the film's extended shoot. Notably, she was the third actress to assume the role. Cecile Aubrey, one of her predecessors, left the production for The Black Rose and coincidentally encountered Welles again on that set. Such casting dynamics, while unconventional, speak to the intricate behind-the-scenes narrative of the 1951 Othello. Welles' meticulous attention to detail, from architectural inspirations to practical problem-solving, underscores the depth of his directorial approach. The film's production challenges and cast transitions provide a fascinating backdrop to the cinematic adaptation. These anecdotes peel back the layers of Othello's making, revealing a tapestry woven with creativity and unforeseen twists, ultimately enriching the viewer's appreciation for this classic piece of cinema. Orson Welles, the acclaimed director of the 1951 adaptation of Shakespeare's timeless tragedy, had a unique experience during the Cannes Film Festival.
In his own words from filming Othello, Welles revealed that he learned about the movie winning the grand prize of the festival just hours before the gala.
In his hotel room, the festival director approached him, seeking the national anthem of Morocco for the orchestra's performance during the award ceremony. The lack of knowledge about Morocco's anthem led to a vaguely oriental rendition, adding an unexpected twist to the celebration. The extensive production of the film is thoroughly documented in Micheál MacLiammóir's book Put Money in Thy Purse. This detailed account sheds light on the challenges, creative decisions, and behind-the-scenes dynamics that characterized the making of the 1951 Othello. MacLiammóir's insights provide a deeper understanding of the intricacies involved in bringing Shakespeare's tragedy to the silver screen. Beyond its initial release, Orson Welles' daughter, Beatrice Welles, undertook a significant restoration effort in 1992. Spending over $1 million, she enhanced picture quality, resynced the audio, added sound effects, and re-recorded the score in stereo. However, controversy surrounds this restoration, with critics questioning its fidelity to the original 1952 version that received acclaim at Cannes. Legal actions ensued, leading to the 1952 version, along with the 1955 cut for the American market, remaining out of print due to disputes initiated by Beatrice Welles. The restoration project, though well-intentioned, stirred debates about preserving the film's authenticity and its alignment with the acclaimed version presented at Cannes. These facets of Othello's post-production history, from the Cannes Festival recognition to the intricacies of restoration, add layers to the film's narrative. The twists and turns off-screen mirror the complexity of the on-screen drama, showcasing the enduring impact and challenges faced by this cinematic classic. In conclusion, the journey of the 1951 Othello extends beyond its initial release, encompassing moments of triumph and controversy. Whether on the prestigious stage of Cannes or in the meticulous restoration efforts, the film continues to captivate audiences and spark discussions, attesting to its lasting significance in cinematic history. As the curtains draw to a close on this cinematic journey, through the enigmatic tapestry of human emotions, one cannot help but be entranced by the timeless allure of this 1951 masterpiece. The silver screen, a mirror reflecting the intricate dance between love and betrayal, has woven an indelible spell, leaving an imprint on the soul. Let the echoes of passion and tragedy linger in the recesses of your mind as you traverse the labyrinth of your own experiences. Like a seasoned traveler, explore the corridors of your heart where the resonance of this cinematic opus finds its dwelling. Unearth the memories, both vivid and subtle, that this celluloid symphony has inspired within you. Have you found yourself swept away by the intoxicating currents of love, mirroring the tempestuous seas that shape the destiny of our protagonists? Or perhaps the echoes of treachery and deception have stirred a contemplative storm within, inviting introspection on the fragile nature of trust? As we stand at the crossroads of personal connection and cinematic artistry, take a moment to share your reflections, your musings, your personal tapestry woven with the threads of this ageless tale. Let the discourse become a canvas where diverse perspectives converge, each stroke contributing to the rich mosaic of interpretations that this cinematic gem has inspired. Your thoughts are the constellations that illuminate the vast expanse of collective appreciation, transforming this solitary journey into a communal celebration of storytelling brilliance. So, my fellow wanderer, share your sentiments and let the dialogue flow like a river of consciousness, weaving a narrative that transcends the confines of time. Thank you for embarking on this odyssey of thought and emotion with us, for allowing the magic of the screen to resonate in the corridors of your mind. Until our narratives intertwine again, may your reflections be as profound as the cinematic landscapes that linger in the wake of this enduring masterpiece.